All right, YouTube, what's good? It's your boy Demo here, back with another video. And today I will be bringing you guys some gameplay and a quick overview of the KWA TK45C. I know some of you guys have probably already seen videos on this, breakdown videos, review videos, maybe some gameplay, I don't know. But from what I've seen on the internet, there's a lot of reviews out there, but there's not too many gameplay videos. And there's not really any like indoor CQB gameplay videos where people really push this gun to see how it really performs. So hopefully that's what I can achieve with this video. All right, if you guys know me, you guys know I really don't do reviews on my channel. This is not a sponsored video by any means. These are some team guns that we got for the squad and I have them in my possession. So I figure while I have them, might as well do a video with them. The reason why I'm saying them is because we got our hands on a standard edition and the one you guys are gonna see in the video is the special edition TK45C. Now, I know what you guys are thinking, what's so special about it, besides the Cerakote. So they have like this, they have this pretty sick Cerakote up here. We got SYG laser right here, the TK45 logo laser right there. This Cerakote, I don't even know what color to call it. It's kind of got like black cherry vibes. Do y'all see this? I got shot in the finger. That's a blood bubble on my finger, bro. It's disgusting. And it was using this gun too. The difference between the special edition TK45C and the standard TK45C is that this one, minus the Cerakote, has a Gate Titan pre-installed. It comes with a Gate Titan installed. And honestly, I'll tell you guys, that's a game changer with this gun, especially with KWA, with the way that their guns operate. This is a game changer. Because as some of you know, KWA over the years, most of their stuff has been very proprietary, their gearboxes. And the fact that, you know, they have some that come pre-installed with the Gate Titan, very limited by the way, I think there's like 100 rifles. They're probably sold out by now, I don't know. Without going too in-depth on what's metal, what's plastic, and what's what with this rifle, I'm gonna tell you guys just a little bit about the overview and then we'll roll the gameplay. All right, so to go over some external features of the TK45C, you get a three-position collapsible stock, so it collapses all the way in, retracts to a middle point, and then it retracts all the way out. PTS, rear, and front sights, key mod rail. KWA actually includes, I think, two or three of these rail segments. Complete ambidextrous controls, and I mean like literally everything is ambi. Mag release, bolt catch, selector, and charging handle, everything is ambi. You do get the rotary style hop up in there. Now, for the mags on this thing, they're not bad. They hold 120 rounds, which is really, really nice. I ran four of them and I was solid playing indoor. I think that was almost too much until I got super trigger happy. But the mags are pretty nice. My only complaint, and you guys are gonna see this when I roll the gameplay, I think the springs in these are pretty weak. Now, I don't know if it's just the ones that I got, but I was having some misfeeds. But when they fed, they fed, you know, and they fed good. 120 rounds again, it's really nice, it's real solid. I was chucking these mags and they were holding up. It's a really sturdy polymer that they made this out of, so pretty nice. Getting into the special edition, which is the one that I was using, I did have to do a few modifications so that it can perform to my liking, shall I say. First thing I did, shout out to AirTech Studios. They reached out and hooked it up with a battery extension. They also make these for the ARP9. So what's sick about this battery extension is that it literally just TBE, tanker battery extension. It's literally just like a battery extension cap for the TK. Stock goes back over. Now, you can't collapse it all the way, but it does get to that middle selection, which is nice. So the batteries I was running on this were these little Matrix 1300 milliamp 45C 111 LiPo bricks, little mini bricks. They actually sit really, really nicely in the stock here. I think they're only like 26 bucks on eBay. I'll have a link for these in the description. But they do fit the stock really, really nicely. I use these on this. I've used these on DSGs, my SSG. It works pretty damn good. Next up, you guys know how I am with my tracer unit. You guys always ask me what tracer unit this is. This is a X-Cortec XT301 tracer unit, which is the little micro pistol tracer, but they have it inside a housing, which is designed to replicate the SLR RifleWorks comp that I have on my ARP9. Now, Ditac is the OEM of this, but if you guys are looking to buy it, EVIC has it listed as the 6mm Pro Shop tracer unit, or something like that. I'll link it in the description below. But yeah, I got the tracer up front. All the other attachments that you guys are gonna see me using on this gun in the video, I removed them. I had PTS sights on, but I moved those back to my other gun. The grip that I was running on it is the one that I have on my ARP9. That's a Unity Tactical key mod grip. It mounts right on the key mod rail and it's super short really nice. And then the side I actually have with me right here, it is a really cheap replica RMR on a really cheap replica RMR mount. I know only some of you might be familiar with this, but there is a brand out there called Scalarworks, however you pronounce it, but they make these pretty sick mounts for optics. They have them for T1s, MROs, RMRs, they have them for a lot of optics. And I really like the design, so I hopped on Amazon and I found a replica for pretty cheap. I don't remember the price off the top of my head, but I'll find it and I will link it in the description below. And for everyone asking me which RMR this is, I got this off Evic as well. If you guys are looking to pick up a good RMR, this one's not bad. I mean, it gets the job done. It's pretty cheap. It was like $40. If you guys are looking for a good RMR, Helix Airsoft makes a good one. Ace One Arms makes a very good one. And those have trademarks as well. This one's just completely blank and non-trademarked, but it's not bad. It gets the job done. And just to show you guys what it looked like on the gun, let's screw this on right here. Boom. I just think it fits the TK. I think this alone looks really good on any sort of PDW. So I was running this. I had the Unity Tactical Grip, the X-Cortec Tracer, and then I also had a mini Scout Light, a Bravo. It's like a 300 replica that was right here. But yeah, that was the gun setup. Now, when I got the special edition one, the trigger pull, it was okay. But since it has the Gate Titan installed into it, I was able to actually plug the TK45 into the Gate control station, which allows you to open up all kinds of controls for your gate. And I was actually able to tune the trigger sensitivity. Now when I got it, I think the stock setting was at like 3, I put it on 1, which is the most sensitive setting that you can adjust it to. And that honestly helped me out so much with the trigger response. But since this has the Gate Titan in it, I think we might drop a speed trigger in this thing. KWA, I think they're using some heavier trigger springs on theirs. What I'll do real quick is I'll plug a battery in both of these and we'll do like a quick dry fire so you guys can see. So I have that mini brick lipo sitting right inside the stock here. It's really hard to see with the lighting and the camera angle and everything, but it slides right under there. And there is enough room, if this was wired to Deans, to manage the wires up here. Since this is wired to Tamiya and my battery's wired to Deans, I do have an adapter here so we can at least see what the trigger pull's like. All right, so got the battery plugged in. Here's a test fire for you guys. Now here I have the special edition. You guys can see this trigger pull's a lot shorter. Full auto. I actually burst locked it. Totally forgot. Well, that is the beauty of having the Gate Titan in here. And even if you guys are gonna get the standard one, I'd recommend dropping a Titan in or a BTC or something in there. It definitely helps. Now I was gonna do a whole like breakdown with the Gate control station and showing you like what settings I changed and whatnot, but this is the basic module that's in here, so I really don't get too many options. It's either like full auto burst settings or trigger response, like trigger sensitivity. That's literally it. I mean, there are other settings, but I didn't feel like I needed to go that in depth with this video. I just wanted to do a quick overview so that way you guys understood the difference between the two TKs, because I know that there is a lot of hype behind the gun, and yeah. All right, y'all, so I'm actually just getting back to the house after visiting KWA. One of the guns that we had some problems, so we took it back to them. They handled it real quick and got it fixed for us. So the issue we were having with the standard black TK was that the charging handle wouldn't lock back. Minor issue, and then Sosa was telling me that it wasn't firing, so we just took it in just to get it checked in. They fixed the charging handle for us, and they made sure everything was shooting and working fine. So on top of that, I got some extra mags.
And these sick little TK patches.
But while I was there talking to some of the reps, I realized I missed a ton of info in the breakdown. So from what I can remember, that brief talk that I did have with them, the TK45C actually comes with their most recent 2.5 gearbox. And then the longer version, the TK45, actually comes with their KWA 3 gearbox, which is a recoil, which has a felt recoil. Like there's an actual buffer that recoils when you shoot it. Now, another fun fact about the TK45C is that it's their VM4 gearbox, their variable M4 gearbox. So I didn't know this, but it actually comes with a tool, which I don't have because I just got past the gun from my homies. It comes with a tool that you can stick in the buffer tube and you can actually adjust your FPS. I believe the range is from like 330 to 380. So you can go play indoor with it, adjust it, then go play outdoor with it.
pretty dope.
But yeah, I just like remembered some of it right now. If I am missing anything, if you guys know, please drop that in the comments below. Hey yo, I know I'm not the only person who gets serious Titanfall vibes or Apex Legends vibes as well from this thing. I already know someone in the comments is about to be like, R99 here.
Alright, it's live.
Follow me on Instagram. Me too. Aiden underscore Albert06.
Follow Albert, Airsoft is life.
Yeah.
Hey, go follow Dima.
Hey, thank you. Yeah. Thank you, God.
No offense, no offense, SYG.
Everybody shut
Dima's
up.
The best player on SYG.
Oh, my God.
Why you gotta do my teammates like that?
What's up? Is that a Vector?
No, it's a TK45. It's kind of like a... kind of like a Vector and an M4 had a baby, I guess.
Oh, shit. Pretty cool.
Best way to look
what's
at
up,
it.
You're Demo, right?
Yeah.
What's up, man?
What's up, bro?
I said what's up to you last time. I'm the Gravy Seal, man.
What was it?
I'm the Gravy Seal.
Oh, okay, cool. What's up, bro? What the heck? What is this? Oh, hey. Imagine the whole field like this.
There's no sliding, I'll tell you that.
I know, I thought like, what?
You're about to scorpion that bitch.
You got me, bro. Shit. Damn, bro. Hey, good shit, though. You've never seen a rock.
Y'all, so that wraps up this video. If you guys enjoyed it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, hit that notification bell, join the gang, hop in the comments, let me know, would you guys run the TK45, and if so, how would you set it up? Let me know if you guys want to see more gameplay with this. I'm actually going to be in Europe for the SpeedQB Invitational, the first European tournament for one, and it's the first official SpeedQB field. This is like a whole SpeedQB arena, like it's insane. But I'm about to be out there with Sapo for the Invitational. We're going to be commentating and all that. So there's definitely going to be a video of that. And I'm going to see if we can play a little bit. If we do play a little bit, I'm going to see if we can run these TKs and maybe get some gameplay out there. And I'll just bring you guys the full experience with that. But again, before I go, I just want to say thank you to everyone that tunes into these videos, man. Everyone that subscribed. Everyone that is hyped about videos, man. I'll post a video and you guys are commenting first or notification gang or whatever. And I just love it, man. You guys are super patient with me. I've been very, very busy in my personal life, which is why I haven't been posting as consistently. I got some super, super big news and really big announcements coming soon. I'm also working on a whole lot of like personal stuff behind the scenes. But yeah, man, I'm super excited. Things are really about to start taking off even more for me. So thank you guys for tuning in again. It's your boy Demo. Catch y'all in the next video. Peace.